this video we are discussing about relative pronoun. Relative pronoun. Relative pronoun. Relative pronoun is a word that introduces a relative clause. Relative clause. Relative pronoun is a word that introduces a relative clause. It is called relative pronoun because it relates to the word that it modifies.
Okay,
see example. The man is my uncle who is wearing a red shirt. Okay. Let us see the definition first. Relative pronoun is a word that introduces a relative clause. Relative pronoun. This is who is relative pronoun. Okay. So what the statement is saying? This pronoun introduces a relative clause. Means a group of words. Okay. So, this is a clause, a group of words that does not give a complete meaning. Okay. So, that is called relative clause. Okay. So, it is introducing a relative clause to us. Is it? That is called relative pronoun because it relates to the word that it modifies. So, this word is relating to uncle. Okay. So, that's why that is called, it is relating to this uncle. Okay. So, this is, who is giving, who is related to uncle. Is it? So, that's why it is called as relative pronoun. Okay. So, it is, it relates to the word that it modifies. It relate, this relative pronoun is relates to the word uncle. Is it? So, that's why it is called as relative pronoun. Okay. So, let us see some more examples and types of relative pronouns. So, one note is there. Relative pronoun must be used as possible to the related noun, to the related noun. Otherwise, there is a chance of misunderstanding.
Okay.
So, what the note is saying, see here. Relative pronoun must be used. Okay. Must be placed, or we can write. Okay. Must be placed. Must be placed as near as possible to the related noun. So immediately after a new noun, we have to write relative pronoun. Otherwise, there is a chance of misunderstanding they are saying, is it? So let us see example. The pen is red in color. That is mine. Okay, like this, two types of sentences are there. The pen is red in color, that is mine. Okay, so let us see how to combine these two. The pen which is red in color is mine. The pen which is red in color is mine. Okay, so here this which or that we can use. Okay, so here the pen, we are talking about pen. The pen, here we are giving information about this pen. How that pen is? The pen is, how that pen is? Red in color. Which or that we can use here. Okay, which or that we can write here. Okay. Here, the pen, this is relative clause. Okay. This is relative clause. Means a group of words. Okay. Which does not give complete meaning. See here, is red in color means, is there any clearance in this group of words? No, is it? Again, there is a question mark in our mind. So that's why it is called as clause. Okay. So here, this clause is describing about this pen. Okay. So pen which is red in color. So here, this relative clause is talking about pen. How that pen is? The pen is red in color. Okay. So now it is the information about this pen. Okay. This which or that is giving information about pen. Okay. So the pen is mine. That is okay. Is it? But here by using which, we are giving extra information about pen. Is it? So that's why we have to use which as near as possible. Here we wrote, is it? As near as possible to the related noun. Means to what we are describing. Means we can misunderstand for what it is describing. Okay. So that's why we have to use immediately after a noun. Okay. This is about this note. Okay, what the note is saying? Relative pronoun must be placed as near as possible to the related noun. Means relative pronoun must be used as near as possible to the related noun. Means this noun, after the noun there must be a relative pronoun. Otherwise, there is a chance of misunderstanding. Otherwise, we may get confusion, misunderstanding, they are saying. Okay. So, there are two types of relative. Who? Whom or for now living things, simply arrangement. Okay, whom for living things, living things. Okay, which that for non living things. Okay. Who? Whom for living things. Which? That for non-living things. Okay, let us see examples, you can understand. Okay, so let us see example of who. Okay, example of who. Okay, she scolded. She scolded a man. The man is trying to cheat a girl. See here. She scolded a man. The man is trying to cheat a girl. Okay. So here, instead of writing two sentences, we can write simply one sentence by using relative pronoun. Okay. So by using relative pronouns, we can make two sentences in a one sentence. Okay. Let us see. She scolded a man. A man, we have to give information about that man. That man, who is that man? He is trying to cheat a girl. She scolded a man who is trying to cheat a girl. To cheat a girl. See here, she scolded a man. Okay. In the next sentence, we used the man is trying to cheat a girl. Okay, again we wrote the man here. Is it? So, by using who, we can remove that man. Okay, instead of writing again, we can write simply a form by using who. Okay, so she scolded a man who is trying to cheat a girl. Okay, so here this is from is. To cheat a girl. This is relative clause. Means it is giving more information about this man. Okay. This man comes under relative pronoun. Relative pronoun. This is clause. Okay. This is noun. So, for this noun, by using who, we are giving more information. Okay. So, this is about who example. Okay. Next, let us see example of whom. Example of whom. Example of whom. Okay. I met a person. The person is a lawyer. I met a person. The person is a lawyer. Okay. So here we can club these two sentences by using a relative pronoun, that is whom. Okay. The person whom I met was a lawyer. Okay. See here, the person whom I met was a lawyer. Here, like this also, we can write. I met the person who was a lawyer. Like this also, we can write. Okay. So, here, this was a lawyer. This is a relative clause. It is giving information about this person. Okay. So, that's why, see here, if the person is here means we may get confused. Is it? So that's why we have to write immediately After a noun, we have to use relative pronoun. Okay. I met the person. The person whom I met was a lawyer. Next, let us see example of which. Example of which. So, I said that which is used for non-living things. You see? So, which is used for non-living things. Okay? See here. The sun is very hot. The sun is very hot. It gives us light and heat. It gives us light and heat. The sun is very hot. It gives us light and heat. Okay. So, there are two sentences here. Is it? The sun is very hot. It gives us light and heat. Is it? So, by using relative pronoun, we can club these two sentences. Okay. The sun, which gives us light and heat is very hot. Okay, see here, the sun. Okay, so immediately I used what? Which is relative pronoun. Okay, the sun. Okay, this is a noun. So, this noun is describing here, gives us light and heat. Okay, this is relative clause. Okay, this is relative pronoun. This is relative clause. This is relative clause. Okay, the sun here. Which is talking about sun. Okay. So, the sun. How the sun is. How it is helping us. Somewhat information it is giving. Gives us light and heat. The sun gives us light and heat. He is very hot. How the sun is? Very hot. Here, gives us light and heat. This is extra information about sun. Okay. So, for that we are using which. Or, we can say like this. For clubbing two sentences. Okay. So, here we wrote two sentences separately. Is it? So, instead of writing two sentences, we can write in simplest form in one sentence by using relative pronoun. Okay. Let us see example of that. Relative pronoun. That. Okay. So, let us see example. The book is very old. It is an interesting book. So, like this they will go in the examination and they will ask to us to combine these two sentences by using relative pronoun that. Okay. So, that is used for what I said for things. Is it? What is the thing here? We can club these two sentences by using that. The book that is very old is an interesting one. The book that is very old is an interesting one. Okay, the book that is very old, is an interesting one, interesting book, we can say, okay. Interesting book. Next another one example, okay. I saw a movie. The movie was very horrible. Okay. So like this, they will give two sentences in the examination. They questions us to write these sentences by using that. Okay. So I saw, we can club like this. Okay. I saw a movie that was very horrible. That was very horrible. Sima, how we have to club means? That was very horrible. I saw a movie. The movie was very horrible. Okay. I saw a movie. As it is, we can write. So here we are describing about a movie in the second sentence. Is it? So what we are describing in the second sentence, beside that we have to write that. Okay. So we are describing about the movie here. See here in the second sentence, the movie was very horrible. So in the second sentence, we are saying that the movie was very horrible. Is it? So that means that we are describing the movie here. Is it? So that's why beside the movie, we have to use relative pronoun. About what we are describing, after that only, immediately we have to write that. Okay. So that's why I wrote, I saw a movie that was very horrible. Okay. So here, about what we are describing, after that, immediately we have to write that. Okay. Relative pronoun. Okay. This is the usage of that. Okay. So we have to use relative pronoun, that, immediately after the noun. Okay. After the noun, we have to use that, okay? About what we are describing. This is about that.